How many of you would have posted or shared something on the social media in the last, let's say, 2 days? Something that you have created, not just liked. Tweeted, posted, shared, update status. Very few hands, I'm surprised actually. Interesting crowd. Okay. How many of you have signed an online petition for anything that is relevant to you in the last 1 year? Okay, couple of hands going up. Great. If there was an interview tomorrow for a job, okay, how many of you for a confirmed interview would not turn up? One will not turn up for a confirmed interview. Okay, thanks for the guys. If you had a volunteering assignment tomorrow where you had said somewhere ki main kal aaunga bachchon ko padhaunga or you know I will come for a cleanup drive or whatever it is, how many of you in reality are likely to turn up? That's a good number, but the statistics that we have usually don't support that. So there are two instances over here where the statistics didn't support that. So one was it the number of online donation versus online shopping, and the number of people who would drop out of an interview versus the number of people who would drop out of a volunteering assignment. So those two, the numbers that I'm getting from you definitely doesn't show up in the statistics that we usually have. So what is the social responsibility in the digital age? I think that's what I'm going to talk about. But let me start with where we started, my journey. So how many of you are aware of the Y2K challenge? Suna hai kisi ne? Y2K challenge? Keval first row wala six mein kar raha tha main, to ek hi haath upar gaya, Y2K challenge. और एक दो स्पीकर चले गए हैं अभी, नहीं तो उन लोगों ने भी शायद हाथ उठाया होता है Y2K चैलेंज. वन ऑफ यू नोस दिस, यू नो व्हाट इट इज? आई सॉ अ हैंड. या ओके कूल. सो Y2K जैसे सब चीजों का नया टर्म होता है. Y2K स्टूड फॉर द ईयर 2000. ईयर 2000. सो Y2K एंड व्हाई वाज Y2K अ चैलेंज? बिकॉज़ ईयर 2000 से पहले 80s और 90s में जितनी भी प्रोग्रामिंग हुई थी, अ लॉट ऑफ इट dates are important in everything that you do, right? So incidentally, it was realized that a whole lot of places, the dates that were used were not, the years were not in four digits, not 1999. It was only 99 or 56 and not 1956. So in a very, very simple way, the world would come crashing down, all the IT and technology and internet would possibly come crashing down for a lot of companies and people in the year 2000, when it changes from 1999 to 2000 and then thereafter 2001, because 1901 or 2001 ke beech mein koi difference nahi hoga, dono 01 or 01 honge. So that in a very simple thing was a Y2K challenge, and in 99 it was a big talk. Everybody was talking about the Y2K challenge. Why am I talking about over here is because 99 was also a time when I was doing my MBA, and from a special B school which focuses on rural and social development, it's called Institute of Rural Management in Anand. And as part of the 2 year MBA program, we were required to spend about 6 weeks working in a village, trying to live with a family and work with a family in a local dairy cooperative. So I was in a small village in the district called Barabanki next to Lucknow in Uttar Pradesh. I belong to UP. So वहाँ पे काम कर रहा था मैं, and radio सुनते हैं बहुत लोग अभी कहते हैं मैं वहाँ पे FM नहीं था, radio होता था. And one of the farmer family that I was staying with, they asked कि ये Y2K क्या होता है? हम लोग रेडियो पे सुनते रहते हैं Y2K 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 होता क्या है, Y2K प्रॉब्लम क्या है. नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड इट इन लाइक अ मिनट, राइट? बट इन ईयर 2000 देयर वर नो कंप्यूटर्स इन द विलेज. ऑफ कोर्स देयर वर नो फोन्स, पीपल हैड नेवर सीन अ फोन, फॉरगेट अ मोबाइल फोन. नाउ हाउ डू यू एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ Y2K टू अ फार्मर हु एक्चुअली इज ऑन अ ब्लॉक कार्ट? वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. हम लोग बड़े स्मार्ट डूड टाइप के लोग हैं, हम समझा लेंगे. सो वी ट्राइड एक्सप्लेनिंग हार्डवेयर क्या होता है, सॉफ्टवेयर क्या होता है. तो ब्लॉक कार्ड जो है वो हार्डवेयर हुआ, ठीक है, जो उसको चल रहा है उसके पीछे, जिसको चला रहा है वो सॉफ्टवेयर हुआ. सॉफ्टवेयर का कोई सोचेगा कि वो कैसे चलेगा, दैट्स हाउ टेक्निकल रन. वी ट्राइड रियली हार्ड लेकिन फेल्ड एट इट. वहां से द रियलिटी स्ट्रक दैट वट एवर यू स्टडी, वट एवर यू प्रैक्टिस, वट एवर योर स्किल्स आर, इफ दे आर अनेबल टू कनेक्ट to a problem that people face in day-to-day life in a manner in which they understand it, then jo pada wo sab bekar hai. So for example, brands, loyalty. Yeah, why does a shirt cost anywhere from 1500 rupees to 5000 or possibly even 15000 rupees? Why does a suit cost in anywhere from 2000 rupees to 2 lakh rupees? when a bullock actually in 2000, that pair of bullock would actually cost possibly 4,000 rupees for a pair. Today I don't know the cost, but that time it costed that much. And a bullock would actually mean, a pair of bullocks would actually mean an entire livelihood for an entire family and a large family over years versus a cost of a shirt. So when things don't match with each other is when possibly you start thinking about what is the role that I play, and which is what I'm talking about here today. All of us want to believe that India is a developing country. We used to say, now we're trying to change that and say that India is no longer developing, but it's actually a developed country. But can a nation, a country really become truly developed unless its citizens actually play a positive role in its development? And that's where the, you know, we all of us think about the American society, ki wahan pe bahut zyada freedom hai, sab log padhe likhe hain, and a lot of equality. You think of the Japanese society, you think of the technology that is available and the innovation that is available. Yesterday I was listening to some piece that said Korea is being ranked consistently as one of the most innovative societies. But what is the role that people play in each of these societies? Is it only innovation? Is it only kind of marketing? Is it only consumption? No, there's one of the most active forms of volunteering also happens in all the European countries, particularly the northernmost parts of it, you know, countries like Denmark and Netherlands and Finland and Sweden and Switzerland. And of course the US and Canada, and the other side, Australia, Italy, Germany, Japan, Korea. These are the places jahan pe volunteering maximum hai. Jahan pe volunteering maximum hai, wahi par jo hai development bhi maximum hai. So obviously there is some kind of correlation which is there. So my own journey, we thought that we'll actually build something that would be called a portal. Portal, isko pata hai kya hota hai? What does the portal mean today?
Website.
Website, okay. I thought that portal mein aise kuch aur denge log ki portal jo aaj kal denge, a lot of sci-fi movies you actually see a portal which, you know, people actually jump into and land in some other site. So I thought that'll be more important. But in 2000-2001, websites or platforms as they are called today, platform was not a word, apps were not there, but a portal was a thing. So Rediff and Yahoo used to have to be the big portals, and we thought that we'll actually make a portal that will help connect people to for non-profits working volunteer. But obviously that was not to be. It took us from year 2000 till 2003, almost about, you know, we began at the end of 2000 and in early 2003, almost about two and a half years, when we realized that website se kuch hoga nahin, platform se kuch hoga nahin. So everybody has spoken about the great aspects of the digital world, but I'm going to talk about the digital world, how it connects with the real world. So whatever we did in the first 2 years, we actually had almost in that time about 5,000 volunteers registered with us, which is a pretty good number. And about 250 non-profits registered with us. By the end of the day, there was hardly about 50 volunteer connections that happened on the ground. The problem was that we were trying to replicate something that did not exist. We were trying to create a culture that did not exist. And so in 2003 onwards, we moved from a digital space into actually having iVolunteer centers, physical centers where people could actually go and meet other non-profits, meet one of our own volunteer leadership managers. We have these iVolunteer centers in cities like Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Kolkata and Pune that enable people to kind of volunteer more and more. And life is coming full circle now. In 2018, 2019, the web has started again giving us the maximum amount of volunteers. But the challenges remain. The number one challenge is, you know, typically you're always told that well begun is half done. In general in life and in volunteering in particular, well begun is only, you know, is only partly done, not even half done. It's only partly done. So a lot of hands will go up. If I were to ask you, kal mere saath mein volunteering karne kaun kaun aayega, gari bachcho ko padhane ke liye ya ke safai karne ke liye, a lot of hands will go up. How many hands? Can you just show once? Thode thode ja rahe hain upar. Theek hai. Lekin kal kya hoga, that, you know, after this design, people will forget. After liking, you actually tend to forget what is there. But this is just one element. How much are you willing and prepared to understand? For example, a lot of people come and tell us that Saturday free hai, Saturday, every Saturday I can go and teach a child. That is what they tell us on the digital medium. In reality, when we have a conversation with those people, normally Saturday ko kya karte ho aap? Kabhi movie dekhne chale jaate hain, kabhi extra assignment hota hai, kabhi girlfriend se milna hota hai, time nahi hai, right? And if you're in the working space, then possibly you're traveling somewhere, you're traveling overseas, you have an interview, your boss called you to office, things like that happen. So people are unable to even understand that what is it that, what is the real time that you have that you can actually give out. And that's a conversation that we have. So it's a mix. We always believe that it's a mix of what you are able to do in the digital world versus what you are able, what you really are in the real world. End of the day, the digital role that you play, the digital avatar that you have is only one of the personas that you have in real life. Somewhere I read this very nice quote. It said, don't compare your Google searches with other people's Facebook or Instagram posts. Did you understand the difference? Don't compare your Google searches, because Google पे हम वो search करते हैं जो हमारी problems होती हैं और हमको solution ढूंढने होते हैं. Don't compare it with what people post on Instagram and Facebook, because Facebook and Instagram पे वो post करते हैं, हमारी problems post नहीं करते हैं. हम केवल अपनी dreams post करते हैं, केवल happiest moments post करते हैं. And the problem in the mind starts happening when you start comparing कि मेरी problems ये हैं versus लोग तो इतना बढ़िया कर रहे हैं life में. So digital world also has a way of lulling you, of actually giving you that this is a dreamy kind of a world, that is everything is going nice and happy. So take one step out and actually check the reality and figure out who as a person you are and what is it that interests you, what is it that troubles you. Is the traffic problem troubling you? Is the corrupt policeman troubling you? Is it that the world forest fire, the Amazon forest fire troubling you? What is troubling you? What is it that actually you get angered by? What is it that drives you? What do you feel passionate about? And then say, can I do something about it? Possibilities are amazing. So this one interesting volunteering task that happened, and okay, when normally when we talk about volunteering, we say about things like, do you have a time to teach a child? Do you have a time to go out and clean a street? Do you have a time to actually go and spend time in an old age home? But that volunteering happens in mass. But what is it that you can do more than some of those things? This is one example. So there's an NGO called Educate Girls. It is the largest NGO in India that works on educating girl children, active largely in the western and central India, began from Rajasthan. One of the key management problems that they had was that they have village social workers. Village social workers are women who actually go to a village and are responsible for finding out ki school mein bachche ja rahe hai ki nahi ja rahe hai, mid-day meal mil rahe hai ki nahi mil rahe hai, counseling the children, counseling the teachers and counseling the parents. The problem that this NGO had was there were thousands of these workers. But the NGO had no idea, wo worker us gaon mein gaya bhi ki nahi gaya. Did he actually go to that village or not? Forget about doing the task. What is the answer or what is the solution? So we found a company called Limebridge Technologies. They had a group of volunteers called, they called this Warrior Tribe or something, I forget the name exactly. They made a very simple app that would be loaded onto the 1500 rupees, the cheapest possible mobile phone that each of that people, person was carrying. And all that person was required to do was reach that village, check in, come out of that village, check out. The minimum information that that particular NGO Educate Girls got was ki mera jo village social worker tha entered this village with a geotagging which was there and timestamp that was there. So this point of time to this point of time he was there at this particular geography. One critical management problem solved for a very large organization by a couple of hours of coding by a couple of volunteers. So just one example of how things could change. But there's so many things. For example, we spoke about TikTok videos and you post TikTok videos about, you know, about several things. But why not actually help an NGO or a cause by creating a TikTok video or just any video that you post on a YouTube or on a Facebook channel? Why not sign an online petition? Why not actually just go out there and help? For example, you see all these nice, a logo, nice creative. If you're a creative person, you can actually do that. You can create a creative and help an NGO raise its voice by doing this. So it's not just about using your time. It's much more about using your skills. So 45% volunteers believe that they gained management and leadership skills. 45%. Tell me the amount of people who attend a leadership classroom in a college actually feel that they have learned a leadership skill. I can tell you from experience, it will not be more than 15 to 20%. But if you volunteer a couple of hours, people, this is the feedback that 45% believe that they learned management and leadership skills. And believe me, that when you go out in the real world, finding a job and trying to work, it is not your core technical skills that will take you far. Core technical skills are extremely important. But what will take you further and further away is the ability to be a leader, is the ability to be able to manage your own work and everybody else's work. 45% gain, 40, 6% people gained communication skills. Today we will talk about the most important skills other than your immediate skill is actually about communication. If you are unable to communicate with your peers, your co-workers, your seniors, your clients, your consumers, then you are nowhere. So interpersonal skills and communication skills are extremely important. You will learn them, and more than again, almost close to half the people. 34% people gain hard skills. Now what are the hard skills? So an example is that, you know, think of two things. One is you are a creative guy, okay, who has joined a large media company. In the large media company, you are a chotu person. Okay, so you are given some minor task. Ye kar lo ja karke. Or if you are in a large company like, let's say, Unilever, sorry for putting that name, and you are a marketing intern, you will get some little EA prepared survey, and you will deliver karke aana hai. Okay, you will just collect responses. You don't learn much. But if you are in the non-profit, or if you are volunteering, you get bigger tasks. A non-profit will tell you, I'm happy that you are there, you are somebody. Can you develop a logo, not just a logo, but an entire concept of communication and marketing for me? So you are able to gain on hard skills as well, which later on count exceedingly well in your CV, in your biovita, in your LinkedIn profile. We get college going kids, or the standard 11 and standard 12 kids of people who want their kids to actually go and study abroad, to come to us and say that we want to volunteer for 2 weeks to 4 weeks, because we are able to write a very nice statement of purpose that helps you get an admission into American university. It's mandatory for in management schools like IIMs, SPJN, several management schools to actually go out and volunteer for 2 weeks to 4 weeks. Mandatory. Why? Because it gives you these many amount of things. So I just want to kind of, you know, say that keep care, take care of two different things. One is, don't forget the motive for which you are doing all of this. So like everybody else said, that you have to have an objective, and there are obstacles that you have. If you have an objective, then use everything in your way to actually achieve that objective. One of the ways I am telling you is to go out there and volunteer. Second, do not forget that you are an individual, a human being, a social being. You will not survive in this world purely by earning an income. You will not survive in this world purely by actually learning a skill. You will survive by having friends, family, community, society, by actually doing good. You will feel good, you will make others feel good, you will make more friends. You have a real person, there is a good person inside you. But most often what the social media sees is only a outer shell. So create, you know, you have different avatars. Bring out that inside goodness of you also, and create that avatar in the digital space. And as one of my friends said, and I will end with that, earlier we used to have this saying, and it's very popular in India in general, neki kar aur darya mein dal. You heard about it? Neki kar aur darya mein dal. So do good and forget it. Yeah? But I think in this new age, social media age, neki kar aur Facebook pe dal, neki kar aur Instagram pe dal. Because at the end of the day, you know, it's the world that has to regain its meaning. It is you who has to regain your meaning. So if you are able to do something nice and create, describe it nicely, maybe you'll inspire a whole lot of generation of people to go out and volunteer and do something good for yourselves. Thank you.